Previously on Quantum Break.
Paul!
Stop! Come back, goddammit!
I think it's time you tell me what you know.
I know your brother built the one thing that could stop the fracture.
Second time machine.
No.
What?
Goddammit!
We can't fix the machine, but I might know somebody who can. Sophia Amaral.
The Monarch scientist.
She'll be at the Monarch Gala tonight, but security's airtight. She'll be nearly impossible to get to.
Unless I have an invite.
Martin, I'm afraid you're going to have to cover for me at the speech tonight.
All right.
Jack and I have a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah.
Security was tight at the Monarch Gala. You took quite a risk walking into the lion's den.
If we were going to kidnap Dr. Amaral, then we needed to do it from the inside.
Beth Wilder. You were quick to trust her.
We had common interests.
Is that all you had?
It's all we needed.
Well, I was starting to think seeing a pretty lady like you is too much to hope for.
Why don't you keep your mouth shut while we get some privacy before we begin?
How about you get me out of this chair?
Stop squirming. And you're gonna need this.
Appreciate it.
Sure.
What's it look like out there?
I think you're secure. Everyone's concentrating on the party. So far, your crazy plan's working.
And Dr. Amaral?
I don't have a fix on her. She's either at the party or at her office at the R&D facility here on the island. I'll scout out the party.
So you're gonna sip champagne while I break into a high-security installation. Looks like you got this all figured out.
I'll save you a cocktail, weenie.
Oh, well, in that case...
My cover isn't gonna survive the night, but it'll last a little longer, so you can't walk out the front door with me. This is the quickest way to the R&D facility. I disabled the security at the back door, but there'll be guards. Contact me when you're clear. And Jack, you know what's at stake here. This can't be about revenge.
I'm not here for Paul.
Hey! He's escaping!
Will hurt in the morning.
My powers were growing. I was learning to control them better. That felt good.
Very sci-fi and very monarch. Something tells me it wasn't commissioned by them, though. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
I see a radar tower up ahead. Let me know when you're inside.
Oh, you could have warned me about that one, Beth.
Okay, how am I getting to that radar tower? need to get across somehow. Up you go.
It was just our people there. We can spin it however we want. Call it an accident. Or pin it on Joyce.
Yeah, he might as well take the mess he made.
Time felt broken here.
It's locked.
The timeline of the old cannon felt loose. I could shift it around.
Okay, quicker next time. Smart place to aim the cannon, you guys.
I've been thinking. Monarch projections say these stutters are getting more frequent. If one hits while we're grabbing Dr. Amaral...
You'll be frozen. Yeah, I know. It's a risk.
Monarch specialist troopers have the stutterproof gear. I bet Dr. Amaral would have that in her office too.
I'll keep an eye out. See if I grab it for you.
I heard Serene met with Joyce and Locke.
Yeah, I heard he took a personal interest. Somebody said it's because they both got...
Stay sharp! He's here!
Hours.
Now!
Shoot Joyce!
Need to get to the radar tower. Beth? I'm at the radar tower. Where's the lab?
Below your feet. It's all top secret.
Hello, River.
The elevator inside will take you down.
Happy to spend
seriously?
Fine evening with you, good
what is this,
folks.
A Bond villain lair?
We're gonna have a good time.
You but have if no idea. Just don't fall into the shark tank.
We're not gonna be the only ones. Very exciting, very exclusive.
Fuck.
Our gala is tonight at their beautiful mansion on Gull Island. Of course, the event's invite only, and when they say exclusive, they really mean it. Word is even confirmed A-listers have had a lot of trouble securing an invitation. Predictably, rumors are already circulating. Some people are saying that this is not just a party, that there might be an important announcement about Monarch's future coming up. Lots of people are anxious to get in on the ground floor on whatever the new thing, if there is one, might be. It's no secret that when Monarch Solutions makes a move, it pays off. Well, I suppose we'll just have to wait and see. You'll hear about it as soon as I do, listeners. In the meantime, those of us with a view of the river will be able to enjoy the fireworks show, which is bound to be spectacular.
Somebody this handsome, I know.
Speech is streaming.
Unfortunately, Mr.
Give Monarch the audience he deserves.
Preoccupied with as many duties necessary to assure we maintain control over our path forward. And that's what tonight is about. The future. We all knew this day was coming, even if many of you out there aren't sure what it means. We're entering a new phase in our operation. One that presents new risks and new demands. One that requires this. The Cronon Field Regulator, or CFR. Now, many of you know that this device has been the source of our Cronon research since 2010. But what only a select few of you know is that this device is at the center of Monarch's plans to navigate through the dangers of the future. This device.
Everybody get down!
Jesus, what the hell's that about? Hey, Beth, I'm headed down into the labs.
Okay. Bit of confusion here at the party. Serene's right-hand man's on stage. It was supposed to be Serene.
Yeah, I think Paul was too busy trying to have a heart-to-heart with me to make it. This. and getting more frequent. Device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
Paul visited me in that cell. He said time was a closed loop. Believed the fracture couldn't be fixed. Seeing the scale of that facility made me wonder. Time to end it? What was it all for? All right, that's it. The chart showed that all of Monarch's major technological advancements started in 2010. Around the same time that something else happened.
Ground Zero.
Get to Dr. Amaral's office.
The alarm would trigger as soon as the stutter broke. I was on borrowed time.
Looks like I need to find another way inside.
Thank you.
parkour. Which way is Amron's office? Guessing this isn't the usual employee route.
I knew that Monarch had technology to let their soldiers move in stutters, but this was bigger than that. Somehow, time flowed normally in that area. Suddenly, Monarch's lack of concern about time stopping made a hell of a lot more sense.
Dr. Amaral's office must be close. No alarms. Looks like nobody here knows about the mess I made on the way in. Nice job, Beth.
Guns made to operate in a stutter. Paul had clear priorities. When time ends, guns don't. It was technology that allowed people to move inside a stutter.
But too heavy to carry, I assume.
That's why I had to find the lighter model. In Amaral's office.
That's Amaral's office.
Amaral had tried to warn Paul. The end of time was approaching quickly. Less than 24 hours away.
Mr. Serene believed it would take years to run its course. Admittedly, he was wrong.
That there looks like what Beth wanted. Oh, shit. Amaral's at the party. The stutter won't last. I better find a way out of here and get to the party.
Quite expensive piece of tech you stole.
Bill me. I knew Beth's cover wouldn't last long. Had to get it to her at the party before it was too late.
Thank you. sounds like the way out of this place.
All I had to do was make it through the garage. Seems simple enough.
Open fire! Forward! Alert!
Well, shit.
Jack Joyce is in custody and is now present at the R&D facility garage. Repeat, Jack Joyce has escaped custody. He is to be neutralized at all costs.
Easier. gotta be a way out of here. Damn. The alarm must have locked everything down. Maybe I can turn it off.
Adventures in Flesh by L. Hakola. Chapter 11.
Is someone playing an audiobook
when
or
the Archibald
radio?
Finally
whoever that is, shut it off now.
His dungeon.
I think I'll just leave that right there.
Somebody find out where that's coming from. This is supposed to be a secure channel.
Stress. He was still dressed in his impeccable suit of softest velvet, wearing the horn-rimmed glasses that gave him an air of...
Talking about. Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Want to be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
You see, Hash getting shot at was an insider job. I create a window for us, but Serena's looking for you. Remember what we said. I'll keep him occupied, but switch to the Monarch frequency to make sure you stay out of his crosshairs.
Okay. I'll see you at the party. That's the last of them.
Good evening, Riverport. It's Teresa here again. I've got a fresh bagel and a big cup of coffee and a perfectly lovely audience. And everything's all right in my world. Why don't you give me a call and tell me how things are going in yours? We can... Oh, that was quick. That's our first caller on the line. Hey, caller, you're on the air. with Teresa.
Hey, Teresa, it's Spencer.
Hi, Spencer. What's going on with you?
Not much. Cooking spaghetti, listening to you. Just wanted to say hi to my husband, starting his shift at Fire Station 12.
Well, let's hope he's listening. Thanks for that, Spencer. Let's go to our next call. Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, this is Gail.
Nice to hear from you, Gail. What's on your mind?
Well, my boyfriend was at the protest last night, and he hasn't come home.
Oops, looks like we lost Gail there. Cell phones, am I right? Well, let's take a little look at the weather. It's a nice fall evening with clear skies and that lovely crisp autumn air. What could be better than that? Just a nice quiet moment we can all enjoy.
I need the exact coordinates for Joyce ASAP. Monarch Actual is moving in to intercept.
Five. Just spotted him entering the tunnel system outside the party grounds.